Derek and Sonya here, another edition, and we talk.
Why are you laughing, man?
This is serious stuff here. So we haven't vlogged. Okay, so we send out the last one. We did that 3 weeks ago. And we're sending out this one. I'm not sure when. So those of you who are like vloggers, and you know, we know the really true purpose of vlogging is to be consistent. Every week at the same time, that's what the experts say. We're not going to be that. Right, honey? We just can't do that.
It's just our lives won't allow
it. We won't be able to. So we're going to give you as much as we can. So you may get a vlog for the next 3 weeks, but then it's going to be a standstill. Because that's just a lot. But we're on vacation.
Mm-hmm.
Vacation. We are actually on vacation.
Now, these last few weeks, we've been humdingers.
Yeah.
Humdingers, man.
So we're taking a break from what we do as a profession, as clinicians. And we're going to do us. Right, honey?
Yep.
You're going to do me, right, honey?
Yep.
Oh.
Did you just say that?
We're going close. Be gentle.
What are we talking about?
We're going to talk about fear. What are your fears in marriage? You can see Sonya's about to go get a procedure done. And I asked her the question, she afraid she's like, wow, it's a procedure. But maybe I'm projecting my fear onto her. Let's talk.
Well, Derek's a hydrochondriac.
Hydrochondriac? It's hypochondriac.
Did I say hydrochondriac?
You said hydro. You want to get some water?
You're tripping.
Stay tuned. Can we talk? Welcome to Can We Talk? We're back in this vlog.
Did you post the other vlog?
No, I didn't post it yet.
Wow. No, we've been busy, y'all.
Was that some shade? Because I didn't post it.
You're in the shade.
No, you threw some shade at me.
No shade.
15 years ago, I've been pissed that you said that.
I know.
But now I'm growing up.
Mm-hmm.
I'm a grown up now. I'm not a man baby anymore. I'm a man now. I can handle that kind of conversation. So no, I did not, but it's going to be put out today, actually. So this vlog here, we're going to talk about fear, and Sonya, we're on our way to, for her to have a procedure done. Would you like to share what that procedure is?
It's a colonoscopy. Okay. Apparently you're supposed to have one when you turn 50, and I'm past that. So my best friend was fussing at me last month, because I hadn't had mine. You need to go get that checked out, blah 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 blah. Thanks, Red. So I'm on my way.
So the conversation of fear took place because I asked Sonya, was she afraid? She said no. And I had to pause and I realized that I was projecting my fear onto her. And a lot of times marriages, they keep couples on talking about their fear. Honey, tell them why I come to talk about their fears.
Well, you know, the thing about it is, marriage, you know everything about the person. And, well, you try to at least know everything about your spouse. And I think when spouses get in conflict, it doesn't always feel safe to tell your vulnerable parts of yourself, because in arguments, it can get thrown back at you. So we've known couples to not share the vulnerable parts of their hearts, like their fears, because people don't play fair when they're fighting. That's why we always talk about fighting fair. I think we even had a vlog about that, maybe in season 2, season 1, one of those seasons. Because when you fight with your spouse, and you know everything about them, it's very tempting to throw those vulnerable, weak, vulnerable, delicate pieces of information about your spouse at them. So it's hard sometimes to trust your spouse with those vulnerable parts of you and pieces of information that could be thrown back in your face. Like, I know so much about you.
Why you gotta put your
hands in my face? But I could actually annihilate you with that information.
Could you not do that while I'm driving? See, I almost hit a car.
You didn't almost hit a car.
I almost hit the car.
So extra.
I'm not extra. I almost hit the car.
Drive the car.
So let me say this. Let me just pause. See, those are the kind of things that we would have been fighting on the way to the appointment. Drive the car. You're extra.
They can check your phone. It's all clear.
I know, right? It is nice.
See how easily you were done with that? We directed you that way.
That was good. That was
See, that's what you gotta do. When your husband gets all hung up, just redirect them to a toy.
That was good.
And project it.
All right, go ahead and finish your point. I'm sorry.
So I said it. That's what I said. That's why.
Let me ask you this, though. Let me ask you this. Gender, husbands versus wives. Why is it difficult, or is it difficult for a wife to share? Is it difficult for a wife to share her fears with her husband? And I want to share with you. I'm going to share with you why it may be difficult for a husband to share his fears.
Okay.
That was a question to you.
Well, I say because there's a
women,
fear.
Women specifically.
Well, because one, men aren't typically taught to speak emotionally. So women are usually apprehensive in sharing because they don't know if their husband is going to be able to relate emotionally to what their fears are.
Pause. That's the nugget. Because men are not. Are you listening? Are you playing with your phone right there, honey?
I'm texting my auntie to let her know.
Aren't you smart? Looking at the... Okay, we're just going to keep it going. So, point number one, the fear for women. The fear is that the husband may not be able to tap into her thoughts about her fears, so she doesn't say anything.
Right. So, what do you do with it? Because we've seen a lot of wives share with us that they'll tell their husband something deep-rooted, deep-hearted, very significant piece of information about themselves, and their husband will say, oh.
He don't know what to do with that.
Or the husband will say, I see.
Or they'll say, why are you telling me that?
Mm-hmm.
You're always talking about your emotions.
Right. Because y'all don't know, y'all mean the men, y'all don't know what to do with it sometimes. And, you know, our job as therapists is to help men and women, some women don't either, identify their emotions, because we have experiences and then experiences create feelings. And if those feelings aren't identified, there's a whole part of intimacy that's missed.
Okay, that word intimacy just mm-hmm. threw the men off.
Put the things on.
How are you going to tell me to drive? There we go again. I don't have the wipers on, honey, because it's interrupting the sound when I record this. So
okay.
I'm periodically.
Bring it down. You're on 10 today.
Well, because you're getting up to seizure and I'm a little anxious. Okay, let me say my feeling words. I'm anxious for the seizure. Okay? I just shared a feeling where you would respond to it.
I appreciate your anxiety. Thank you for sharing that. And as you can see, when Derek has anxiety, then it gets projected in different ways. How does your husband project his anxiety? What does he do with that? Does he throw it back onto you? Do you know that he's doing that? Do you know that he's throwing it back onto you?
Does the husband know that that's what he's doing?
And does the husband know that's what he's doing?
And that's exactly what I was doing.
So you gotta know, and he's gotta know. At least one of y'all gotta know.
If you don't know, then you...
Then you're gonna feed into it, and then it's gonna turn into a conflict that's unnecessary. Back in the day, that used to be us, though, for real. We used to, I used to not be able to see that you were projecting. And once I realized you were projecting, then I have to help him with it, help him with those emotions. So.
Right. And
I'm like, now, babe, are you anxious about something?
But see, and even like back then, because I was projecting, Sonya didn't know how to respond back then, and then she started going New York on me. She start going Brooklyn. Forgive me for those who are from Brooklyn, but y'all know how y'all roll. She went Brooklyn on me, and then she threw the Bayesian in together. So we got the Bayesian and the Brooklyn coming at me like just 3D coming at me.
Word?
There you go right there, word. Who the heck says word? This is not 1984.
Word up. Word up.
Mm-hmm. And that's the code word. Okay, so fear for men. We got sidetracked for a second. It's difficult for a man to share their fear because we were conditioned not to share it. We were conditioned not to share our fears. We were conditioned that you're not supposed to be afraid of anything. You know, and if you were afraid, you didn't say it.
Right.
So then we get married and our wives expect us to be vulnerable with our feelings. But wives, remember, there's some men who have not been taught, trained, told, given permission to share their feelings. So we don't share our fears. And men have a lot of fears. We do. I can't speak for everyone. I want to be vulnerable for a minute. I don't have too many fears. I'm afraid, honey, I'm afraid that I will not be able to provide for my family in a lot of different aspects, financially, and being available if something happens to me. That's my fear. Mm-hmm. That would be the big one because, you know, we have grown over the years, so those fears have been kind of dealt with. But those are my fears.
Thank you for sharing your fears.
You're welcome.
I appreciate that. I think that most men have fears. They're either unidentified or unspoken or unexpressed.
And so, one example, when a man has a fear, he doesn't express it. Mm-hmm. He overcompensates. Mm-hmm. So when you find a husband who overworks, overworks, one of the reasons, not all, but one of the reasons is because of the fear of not being able to provide. Mm-hmm. Or the fear
of failure.
Of failure. Mm-hmm. Or the fear
of rejection.
Come on now, this is my part. Mm-hmm. Rejection. Or the fear of being alone. Mm-hmm. Why the fear of being alone? Because if he's not working, he's by himself, then he has to expect his wife to provide, and he's not doing anything. So alone, and all the other feelings. So
no, and it's not good for men to be alone, and they know that.
Right. So we keep busy.
Which is why, okay, so this is a totally offshot conversation that I'm about to say. And it's going to probably open up a can of worms, but I'm going to say it.
Can you say it in like 4 minutes? Because
yes.
We're almost there.
Yes.
Okay.
This is why men have affairs.
Whoa.
Because if they are in conflict and their wives don't see their conflict or are the cause of their conflict, they don't want to be alone. It is not good for man to be alone. You all were not made to be alone. So you all will poorly, and I repeat, poorly cope with it by finding someone else. It's not an excuse, it's just an explanation. And I remember God telling me, wives, you do not have the luxury of shutting down on Derek and leaving him alone for over 24 hours. You don't have that luxury. Not that he was gonna quickly cheat on me, but because of the temptations known to man, and the fact that men, they won't say that they're afraid of being alone. Instead, they'll just act it out. God was like, don't even put him in that position. Make sure that that doesn't even become an option. So wives, if you're watching this and you're pissed at your husband, he's hurt you, whatever, he ain't acting right, whatever, whatever, find another way to cope with it, but don't leave him alone. It's not good for him to be alone. Okay?
Can I check real quick?
Absolutely.
So here is the response for someone. We said this before. That's just an excuse. That's a cop-out. But you know, tying what you said, I'm trying to hopefully I can tie this in. Tying what you said, when God told Adam, that when you eat of this particular tree, you're going to surely die. That's the reason why, one of the reasons why people have an affair. Because God gave Adam he told him not to do something, and he did it, he's going to die. And so based on that statement, we're going to surely die, then that's when the premise of the affair comes in. He's going to surely die. He's going to do something real stupid.
And it's a separation. Death is a separation. So that act of infidelity is a separation, of him and his from him and his wife, which is death. Separation from God, separation from your wife, death.
Death.
That's an inside joke from a movie, guys.
So we're going to end this vlog because we're at the hospital, Gwinnett Medical Center.
Let me just say this, though, before we go into to that thing. Wives, I know that sometimes it's hard to hear the reason why men cheat and even why women cheat. You know, women cheat for different reasons, though. It's not because of the fear of being alone. That's a whole nother vlog. But if a dog bites you, people are going to actually ask you, why did he bite you? You're going to ask yourself, why did he bite me? Sometimes it's because they're afraid to. They might bite you because they feel threatened that you're in their space. They may bite you because they are angry and they have to take it out on someone. They may bite you because they're hungry. But we will ask the question, why did the dog bite us? If a dog bit us, most people would be like, why did he bite me? Why don't you ask the same question, why did my husband cheat on me? I mean, it doesn't excuse the dog biting me, but I still want to know. And this is the part that most people get hung up on, is that the finding out the reason why doesn't give it an excuse. It helps you understand so that you can resolve the infidelity issue. So not wanting to know, to me, says that you're not healthy enough to hear the reasons why to prevent it from happening again. So I would really like for people to have a broader mindset about infidelity when that happens, because yes, it hurt. It's like a dog bite, but you still gotta know why. You still need to know why.
You know what building you have to go to? That was awful. That was.
It's wellness center, but I think you were supposed to go where the Chick-fil-A was. That entrance.
No.
Okay.
It's all the same thing.
Okay.
Women's Pavilion, labor and delivery. You having a baby?
No.
Medical office.
Okay.
Is that?
Oh, come off the thing. You're on the wrong side. I'm telling you.
Okay, let me make a new turn. So I'm sorry, guys, but we are turning around. But that was a powerful thought, though. Honey.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh.
That was powerful. Mm-hmm. You tell me where to go.
So honey. We're talking off the cuff.
Let me close out. You talk about give me which way to go. So, thank you for watching. Have conversations, y'all. It's time to put your big boy pants on,
mm-hmm.
big girl pants on. You're right, honey. The GPS is telling me that I
this is our back. Holiday special.
Yeah, a holiday special.
Who gets a colonoscopy on Christmas Eve?
I know, right? Gotta get it sometime.
Yeah, we're free. Ain't okay. Got nothing going on.
So now that you know, you gotta say that.
Oh, okay. So what are we talking about? Fears. Share your fears. Because it will explain a whole lot of emotional intel regarding you and your spouse. Share it. Let them know that you're afraid to share your fears and the reasons why. Now that you know, what you're going to do with it. Have a happy holiday. Merry Christmas. Happy New Year.
Okay, so even though we're kind of inconsistent with our vlog, still subscribe to us. Encourage us. Don't be just watching and just saying, nothing. Just say, look, y'all need to put another video out. I know one guy told me that.
He did? Okay.
He said, y'all got to keep going, y'all stop playing. you know who you are.
We're always coming back.
Yeah, but we got to be consistent.
We take our break in between.
So, but we're not back. Consistent, but we're always going to be here.
Yeah.
And we're going to just pray that God gives us
I don't even know what episode this is.
I don't know. We just stopped counting.
Okay. Okay, well, there we go. There we go. Right there.
Oh,
right
okay.
There.
Could you not? Please, stop.
This side, this side.
Oh, you see? Are you being funny right now? Which one is it?
It's that side. Well, wait, let's see.
Go see? What do you mean, go see?
Because she said it's the only building on Wellness Way, right?
It's 721. It's 601. Donna College. That's not it.
No, it must be this.
Do you have the address?
Yeah, it's right here.
Okay, so welcome to marriage. This would have been a big fight right now. Now we're just fun and games. Enjoy these moments.
There we go.
Man.
Over here. Yeah, see? Right? Yeah, see? Yeah. 721. All right, guys.
Okay.
Thanks for joining us on our escapade to find my place for my colonoscopy. Get yours done if you're over 50. This is just a little health bulletin. My doctor told me that colon cancer takes a long time to develop. So people that usually die from colon cancer missed getting the colonoscopy to prevent it. So that's my little health bulletin for you. I'm going to get mine. Stay tuned.
Can I take the camera in there and just kind of run?
Absolutely not. I got to go. You're playing around.
I think I'm going to show this. This is good material.
Can you get me a roti while I'm out?
Are you serious right now? I'm supposed to be in there with you. You talking about a roti?
Supposed to be in there with you?
I need to stay in the room.
All right, let's go. Let's go.
Can I be in the room?
Can we go?
What time is your appointment?
No, I got to be in there.
It's 11 o'clock. It's 5 minutes to 11. You really want a roti for real?
Yes.
From where?
From Golden Crust. There's one out here.
I was going to sit here and just kind of...
You can sit here.
I got to go get a...
Let's go in and get some information, and then when you have time to kill. That's what I want. I haven't eaten in 24 hours. More than 24 hours. I'm hungry.
I get you a roti.
See how easy I can distract the sea vibes?
I get you a roti. What you want with a roti? You want some sorrow? You want a chicken patty?
See how quick I changed the mood? Just groove with me,
just
baby.
With you.
Honey, I have to go
okay,
in.
Okay, I'm sorry. All right, we see y'all. Bye.